We are joined now by Dr. Dave Lalman, our Extension Beef Cattle Specialist. Dave, we're out here at the North Range where you and your team have had some ongoing research for quite a while. Why don't you kind of get us up to speed and then lead us into what the next phase looks like?
Sure. So, you know, efficiency is a big opportunity in the beef cattle industry to improve on feed utilization. The industry's made a lot of progress in that area, mostly focused on the post-weaning phase of the industry. And there's a lot of good reasons for that. But one is that, you know, measuring efficiency on a concentrate type feed is, you know, with the new technology we have available now, it's a lot easier than it used to be. The interesting thing, maybe the opportunity is that about 74% of the feed energy required to produce 1 pound of carcass weight is used by the cow herd. And so we think there's a lot of opportunity to focus more in the future on that part of the industry. And that means more forage utilization, a long stem forage, like, you know, the type feed where a cow makes her living. And that's what our project here at OSU is focused on.
And that's kind of where you're headed as you start the next phase of what's been an ongoing project?
It is. We've spent the last 3 years now developing a feed intake system that's specialized to measure individual long stem dry hay intake, which again is where kind of where a cow makes her living.
We have a couple of heifers here to talk about and kind of compare and contrast. Tell us what we're seeing here.
So these two heifers are on a current experiment. Emma Briggs is the PhD student responsible for this project. And up to this point, we're about, after she's adapted these heifers, we're about 56 days in. So we've got just a couple weeks left. What you've got here is a very efficient heifer and a very inefficient heifer, at least in terms of their weight and their weight gain, their body size, compared to the amount that they consume each day. One of these heifers averages 6 pounds a day less consumption than the other heifer. They weigh about the same. They're both gaining about a pound a day on straight hay. And so actually they're both performing very well. The efficient heifer is quite a bit younger. And it's interesting that, you know, she's able to gain the same and still consume 6 pounds less hay. Pretty amazing when
Sure.
you think about the progress that could be made there.
Well, and obviously this ultimately affects the bottom line and the profit potential, which is always a concern, but more important all the time, right?
Well, and you think about greenhouse gas emissions, how much lower that would be in a heifer that's gonna spend her life out on rangeland grazing.
Now, you and your colleagues out here have done a lot of work in the last few years to upgrade the facilities and make them more suitable for this type of research.
Yeah, we're really fortunate to have a nice facility and a unique facility, unique across the country really, but thanks to some, you know, dedicated alumni that have helped us be able, you know, given us the capability to do that. We've added a set of pens that are designed to conduct cow-calf research. I mean, yes, they are dry lot pens and they look a little bit like a feed yard set of pens, but they are designed specifically to do cow research and cow with baby calves type research.
Well, best wishes to you and the team as you continue this research, and we want you to come back on soon and tell us about all the results.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Excited about that. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Dave.